Hello hitters, welcome back to Tech Tutorials. My name is Ghost. For today's recording, it is going to be really quick. It is just a tutorial video on how to create a live ID. Apparently, someone requested for this video to be uploaded, and I thought, yeah, it's just, you know, an easy task to do. So I jumped into it right away. So what is the purpose of Live ID for us freelancers, or for those people who work with OneForma, ClickWorker, Datamine, Quadrant Resources, TELUS International, what have you? We use Live ID to be able to access UHRS jobs. Okay, and I was told, well, since I'm mainly focused on working with ClickWorker, I was told that I cannot use my UHRS ID with another vendor if it is registered to ClickWorker. I'm not sure if that, you know, goes for all those vendors. Maybe it's just CW, but I cannot vouch for it. Now, tell me what you think about it, or rather, tell me what you know by, you know, dropping down a comment on the comments field below. So let's jump into this quick tutorial. Again, it is how to create a Microsoft Live ID account. So first of all, you can go to Google. You can just search for create Live ID, and the website that you need to access to create a Live ID account is going to be https://signup.live.id. So just click on that. It'll take you to this page. So create an account. So on the request, I was asked to create something like, you know, a qualified ID. I'm not sure what that is, but all the IDs we create are valid. So, all right. So for this one, let's go ahead and start creating a new live ID. So we have to choose an email. You also have an option to use a phone number instead, or get a new email address. So for this one, let me type in here, test1, or let's just say test2021, test September 10, 2021. So that will be the user ID that I want. Click next. Enter the email address. Okay. At now, let's see, outlook.com. There it is. So there will be different domains. You can use either outlook.com or hotmail.com. So for this recording, I'm going to go ahead and use outlook.com as the domain. Click next. So my new email address will be testseptember10, 2021 at outlook.com, and should be easy. After creating your ID, choosing the username, you have to create a password. The password should be at least 8 characters long, a combination of numbers, symbols, and letters. So an example of that will be, let's say, password@123 with a capital P. Okay, so for this one, I'm gonna create one, and just you have an option to show the password that you have created. You also have this icon. It's a teeny tiny icon here, but it's like an eye icon. If you click it, it'll show you what you typed in there. Okay, so check on I would like information, tips, and offers. That is really optional. Most of those emails are going to be spams anyways. So just click next. And here it'll ask for your name. So it depends on you. It is your prerogative if you want to provide your correct information. But working with a platform such as CW or OneForma, sometimes they do require for your legal name to be there. Okay, so let me just put in here, test sept. It's an abbreviation of September. And here, it'll prompt you to enter your country. So for me, I'll go with the Philippines, my beloved country. And with my, put in your birthday, I'm gonna choose a random date here. Let me just say 1999, and click next. And that's it. It is creating your Live ID account. It's loading, thinking, and after that, it'll ask you to resolve a puzzle. So, create account. Please resolve the puzzle so we know you're not a robot. It's like a CAPTCHA thing, but this one is going to be different. So, tap on the arrows to rotate the image. So you have to position it just like so correctly. Click done, and that's it. You're all good. You are now able to create a Live ID account. And for this one, it'll be test sept 10/20/21 at outlook.com. So it's currently signed in. The website where you can create a Live ID account was, where was that? Is signup.liveid.com. So I hope this video helps you out with creating a Live ID. And again, you can find us on Facebook. We have a Facebook group. It is formerly known as ClickWorker Philippines. We changed it to Ghostly Hitters. So the new group name will be Ghostly Hitters and Facebook. For you to be able to join the channel, you have to subscribe to the tutorial channel first, which is this channel. Okay, go to the Facebook group and answer the relevant questions before we can approve your request to join in. We also have a Telegram group. We also have a blogger site wherein you have an option to watch the videos that we have uploaded here in YouTube. You can watch them in Blogger as well. All the links for those will be on the banner of this channel. It's on the top bottom right-hand corner of the tech tutorial channel, I mean banner rather. Okay, so again, my name is Ghost. You have a good day. Boo. Bye for now.